morning, students. So in today's session, we will see about how the first order logic statements will be arrived, because as in the previous session, we see about what is proposition logic and how the proposition logic can able to attain the different kinds of statements, which is taken as a declarative statements, and how the connectivities of logical connectivities will be made between the proposition statements, where we know that the proposition statements will be taken into two types, that is atomic proposition as well as your compound propositions. And we have seen about which kind of statements and all not to be taken in the form of proposition statements, which what we consider to be taken into the first order logic statement, or we consider as a first order predicate logic statement. So predicate represent about what the subject is doing or what the subject is. That is what the general meaning for predicate. So the same thing is applied over in the first order logic statement, which we short we called as an FOL. So in first order logic statement, whatever the limitations that we identified in the proposition logic statement, something like statements, all students are good students, some students are good students, every students are good students, someone likes everyone, everyone likes someone. So this kind of statements and all to be carried out in the name of first order logic statement. So first order logic statement, or we called as a first order predicate logic statements, which will able to taken this kind of statements, whatever we told like someone there exists for all. So this kind of statements and all can able to derive by using some kind of mathematical derivations, which what we called as a quantifiers. We have two kinds of quantifiers that we will see in the presentation. So using this first order logic statement, the limitations whatever we are applied on the proposition logic statement will be attained by the first order logic statement. So what is the specific need of the first order logic statement? So first order logic statement is been coming under the basic of the topic known as an NLP, which what already we discussed in the proposition logic statement actually, that is your natural language processing actually. So the same thing is when you are going for some kind of chaining method, which we called as a forward chaining as well as a backward chaining. So what is the main objective of your forward chaining and backward chaining, which is the background? We have the first order logic statements as well as the proposition statements. We will connectivity all the atomic statements, and we will come to some kind of conclusion, maybe from the bottom to the top or from the top to the bottom. So this is where the chaining will be taken in both forward as well as the backward chaining. So first order logic statement will be under the support of your NLP. That is a basic one. But what are all the limitations that we identified in the proposition logic statements that will be taken and that will be solved by the first order logic statement? That's what we called as an, there is an extension of a proposition logic statement. So in some cases also they will write the statement like proposition order logic statements can also be called as an extension of a proposition logic statements. That is your first order logic statements actually. So let we see about each and every things which what the limitation that we identified in the proposition logic statement that is being solved by the first order logic statement actually. So before going for the first order logic statement, let me see some of the introduction about what is the first order logic statement says for us actually. So it is a another way of a knowledge representation in a knowledge in an artificial intelligence. So what is the way of knowledge representation? So knowledge is the one which is under the background of learning actually. So when you are representing about the knowledge, we have different kinds of representation of knowledge available, as we just see in the proposition logic, as in the first order logic statement. So it is suitable for the NLP statement. That is a very important that what I just told about the background of your first order logic as well as the proposition logic statements, the NLP is available. So first order logic statement is also known as a predicate logic, or called as a first order predicate logic, which already I told what is predicate. So predicate represent what the subject is doing or what the subject is actually. Okay, so that is very important actually. For example, I'm just writing a statement, Ram is a boy. So here, which is a predicate actually, it represents about what subject is doing or what is subject. So here the second point known as what is a subject. So subject is a boy actually. Okay. So in case of your first order logic statement, we call Ram every the statements whatever we taken to be as an object. So that will be taken in the form of an Ram actually. But in case of general English sentences, we called as an Ram that which is a subject verb and followed by the predicate. So here we will call it as a Ram as a object. We can call it as a subject actually. So while we writing over the form of first order logic statement, we will write it function of object, function of subject, which means that boy is a specific function where the boy specific function can have a Ram or a Lakshman or a Kumar or a Kartikeyan. So this will be the subject which is known as a changeable one. which what in artificial intelligence, the derivation, we will call it as a predicate. So whatever the function we are calling now will be called it as a predicate. So the another name of a function we call it as a predicate or a relationship. So predicate of subject or predicate of object. So we will write the statement boy of Ram. So the query is, see, when you are writing Ram is a boy for that particular statement, that is okay, because I am specifically mentioned Ram is a predicate, because what is the predicate I just told? Predicate will represent what subject is doing or what the subject is. So in this two representation of the definition, the second definition is coincide with the example. That is what subject is. The subject is a boy, actually. The subject is a Ram, actually. Okay. So the predicate represent about the boy, and as well as Ram represent about the subject. So this is what they called as in the third point. First order logic statement is also known as a predicate logic or first order predicate logic statement. And first order logic statement is a powerful language that is an NLP that develop information about the object. So now whatever the specific term that we called as an subject, hereafter I'm going to call it that particular subject as an object, which what we called as a Ram. Okay, so that is a representation which is given over here. Maybe the next point it is also giving the same thing. First order logic statement not only assumes the facts. See, when the statement not only assume the facts in the cell, you can't understand the facts represent about the proposition logic statement, because proposition logic statement will be considered about the facts, which is going to be done or which is not going to be done, which is what we called as a declarative statement, which we mentioned in the binary logic statement, or we called as a true or false statements. But first order logic statements are not like that. First order logic statements are having some kind of relationship. For example, I'm just mentioning like Ram is a brother of Lakshman. So Ram is a brother of Lakshman. So what is, again, I'm coming to the predicate. What subject is doing or what subject is. So here the subject is represent about brother. So when I am writing the formula or when I am representation of a first order logic statement, what is the representation? I want to write it predicate of object or predicate of subject. So here the two representation of name is given, that is Ram is a brother of Lakshman. So you can take it in vice versa. Okay. Because I'm given a common name known as brother. So in that situation, I can write it brother of Ram, Lakshman, which represent that Ram is a brother of Lakshman. Or in another way also, we can write it, if the statement we are reciprocally writing Lakshman is a brother of Ram, then we can write it brother of Lakshman, Ram. So now you can understand what is predicate. That predicate will be logic will be applied. The another name of the predicate logic is called as a first order predicate logic statements. So every statements that may be a propositional statement or a first order logic statement, there are some other logic statements available also. Whatever the statement is, maybe we want to follow some kind of syntax, that is to be very important, as well as the semantics. So what is the syntax we followed? Whenever I'm giving the statement, you want to identify what the statement is, which represent about the predicate, followed by the object. So that is very important. Okay. So these are all the basic elements of the first order logic statements. So which are all the things we can call it as a constants? Which are all things we called as a predicate? Which are all things we called as in functions? Which are all things we called as in variables? Connectivities, we already see it over the logical connectivities. We already see it over once if you go for the proposition logic statement. And now we are going to identify the new people to be called as a quantifiers. That is why that particular text and all I given in the blue colors. So quantifiers represent about two kinds of quantifiers will be given. Why? In the sense, whatever the limitation that we applied to the proposition logic statement, that will be taken and that will be rectified by using the quantifiers of for all statement or there exist statement. Okay. And we will identify what is that constants and all. So the constants, or we will taken some kind of terms to be called as a subject. Here the constant will be the name. For example, I'm the Ram and Lakshman, whatever I just take it, that here they take it as a constant actually. Predicates, what the predicates, now you can understand what is brother. Because I'm just mentioned that Ram is a brother of Lakshman. So brother is a predicate. So function, what is a function? What the particular object is holding the function. For example, I'm just mentioning about the Ram. Ram is holding the arrow, or Ram has been holding the arrow in left right hand. So that right hand, that what the object is holding, or what the object is having an attachments to be taken. So that kind of things and all to be taken in the form of functions, because that will be a specific function. Okay, so specific function can be applied to any number of objects as well as the constants. So here is the first thing is we will take in about two kinds of things, what I just told about the quantifiers in first order logic statement. So this is where we are needed of the first order logic statement. So make it very clear why the first order logic statements are needed. So first order logic statements are needed to do this activity. For example, you can see that the universal quantifier, it been represented by this particular symbol. So this is a representation of symbol called as an for all x, for each x, for every x, which means that all students are good, every students are good. When I'm writing a statement, all students are good, students are good is a common term, okay, but all students are good, how I want to represent all students are good? So when I want to represent all students are good, that particular moment of time I will go for universal quantifier, which will represent using this symbol and followed by the variable. So here the variable is very important. Why? In the sense, because when I am writing a statement all students are good, that particular moment of time there may be an n number of students. The student may be the variable x1 will be one variable, x2 will be another variable, x3 will be another variable, and xn will be another variable. So when I'm writing the general representation, I want to write the statement something like for all x. Here for all x represent all to be represented by the universe quantifiers. X, what is the representation of x in the sense x may be in anyone who is going to be a good student. Okay, so that's what we called as an universal quantifier. So this is the quantifier which will able to solve the problem. What is the limitation that we applied on the proposition logic statement that is being rectified by using a quantifier in the first order predicate logic statements? Let me go to the second point, extensional quantifiers. When you go to the extensional quantifiers, it represent about that there exists an x for some x, for at least one x. For example, I'm writing a statement, some students are good. When I'm writing some students are good, there are exist, which means that out of all the students, there are some students exist or some students available, they are all good students. So when I want to write that kind of statements, I want to use a statement known as an extensional quantifier with the representation of this particular symbol. So when I want to use this symbol, okay, then we will write some other statement, what the limitation that is applied on the proposition logic statement that can able to rectify it over here. The statement's called as an, what the statement I just told, all some students are good. Some students like everyone, or someone likes everyone. When I go for someone likes everyone, here someone represent about the extensional quantifier and everyone represent the universal quantifier. So here we need a connectivities to be made between the universal quantifier as well as the extensional quantifier. That is the one point. Second point is, when you go to the note about the universal quantifier, in universal quantifier, they use about implication, which means that whenever the statement that you are applying the universal quantifier, especially, you want to be apply the implies. That is implies because of this, this is happen. If this condition is made, then this will be happen. So that implication is very important when you are applying the universal quantifier. So we can able to very clear whenever the universal quantifiers is going to be applied, you can refer over that if there is a possibility, 99% there is a possibility of applying the implication in the statement. So that is very important. So check it with the statement, whether when you are converting to the statement of first order logic statement, whether it is possible to have an implication or not. The same thing, the note I've been given for the extensional quantifier, whenever the extensional quantifier, that is some students are good, whenever you are doing like this, you want to check it whether it is having an unstatement, that what we called as a conjunctional symbol, which already we see it in the logical connectivities of the proposition logic statements. So these two things to be noted, once ever you are converting your first order predicate logic statement with the given statement. So in what way the general term of sentences will be formed actually? Because already we know that there are two kinds of propositional statements which we taken in the types. The same way when you taken about the atomic sentences. So what is the general atomic sentences, or what is the complex sentences we are taking? Everything we taken to some kind of forms. That's what we already seen over here, that they given very good representation like predicate of term one comma term two comma term n. What is the meaning for this in the sense? For example, I'm just writing the statement, all students are good. All students are good here, they represent what student is doing or what student is. That is the representation of predicate, or what subject is doing or what the subject is. So here the subject represent the subject is doing is a good thing, something like that. So I'm writing a predicate in term one, term two represent about, it may be a one person, it may be in represent the object, it may be a n number of students. So that particular moment of time, I'm giving a statement something like term one, term two. Maybe the another kind of examples also you can see it over that Ravi and Ajay are brothers. When I mentioned Ravi and others, Ravi and Ajay are brothers, this represent that brothers are the predicate. Again, I'm telling what is predicate. Predicate represent what the subject is doing or what the subject is. Here, representation what the subject is. Subject is brothers. So brothers is a predicate. Ravi and Ajay are the terms, which what we called as a constant. Okay. So here the statement, we want to write it in the first order logic statement. We will write it at brothers of Ravi, comma Ajay. Sir, why I want to write it the predicate? What is the main necessity of the predicate? I will tell you. See, when you are using the predicate as a brothers, it's not only for you are writing for Ravi and Ajay. It may be in any two person. So the predicate is a common one, like a function that you are writing over as a method or as a relationship you are representing over for the given statement. So brothers of Ravi, comma Ajay. So in case of Ravi, comma Ajay, I can also place some other people. So in common term, if I want to write it, X and Y are brothers. So I am specifically written over here, Ravi and Ajay, which what we called as a constants. But in case of specific term, or if I want to write it as a generalized term, I will write it as X and Y are brothers. So who is this X and Y? X may be in any term and Y may be in any term. So for the X one, I can able to substitute any kind of name. For Y, I can able to substitute any kind of name. So it is a common statement that can be used by any kind of a statement that will be applied with the relationship of brothers. So when you are writing the statements, if this kind of statement is given, the problem is very simple that we can write it whatever the presentation shows that brothers of Ravi, comma Ajay, you can write it like this. But when you are writing as a common term, you want to use some kind of representation of a variable or the name representation. You can use the X, Y, A, B, A and B or brothers, X and Y or brothers. So once you are writing like this, then it is easy for a substitution for some other statement also. So what is a complex statement? So we know that the complex statement is a combination of your atomic statements connectivity. When you are taking more number of statements, for example, I'm writing a paragraph, that particular paragraph will containing more number of statements which need multiple connectivities. So that particular moment of time, I can go for complex sentences that we will see one by one. So what is the truth about the first order logic statements? So the first order logic statements will definitely having some kind of interpretation specifies about and any kind of a statements represent about it's a symbols, it's a predicate or it's a function. So that is very important once if you are representing over the first order logic statements. And this is a one basic example I want to give it in what way the first order logic statements can able to identify the given scenario. For example, here the scenario is given over is there is a two persons is been standing over here. That is one person will be called as a Richard and another person is called as a John, who is a king. That is why at the top of the John, there is a crown available on the head actually. Even the person is also given with the additional name known as a king. So both the peoples are having some kind of functions like a left leg. Both the peoples are having some kind of relationship that is known as a brothers. Okay. And there are these peoples are called as a constants, which what we called as a King John as well as Richard. So these peoples are called. So this is the representation what in the previous slide you just see about constants, predicates and functions. So here the functions will be called as a brother. Brother is one of the function what the previous slide we just see about Ram and Ajay or brothers. Then we just write it predicate. So that is also we can write it over like this here. Okay. So this is a general representation how the given model can able to convert out of the first order logic statements actually. So here they cleanly mention about in what way the predicates is been made on the given representation. For example, objects Richard and John will be taken as an object symbols and predicate symbol represent about the brothers and atomic sentences. So what is atomic sentences? The sentence which is having a direct sentences, which is not having any kind of relationship or any kind of relationship in the sense any kind of an additional connectivity is not needed to prove the particular statement. So here specifically the diagram shows that Richard and as well as John are brothers. That is why the arrow mark represent in both directions actually. So this represent as an atomic sentence like Richard is a brother of John. Okay, so this statements and all, to be very specifically, we can able to convert it to the first order logic statements. Even the true if condition, that is this if represent if and only if, which is mentioning about the biconditional statements. Okay, that we will see one by one. So this is the universal quantifier. So how the universal quantifiers can be developed, or how the universal can be able to derive from each and every statements as a general statement which is given in the NLP. So the basic thing is you can start it with the syntax that what the statement we know as a universal quantifier, it started with n for all x, for all followed by the variable and the sentence. Okay, so that is what you can see it in this example, what the sentence that they want to convert it, that sentence they given over here, that is for everyone. If she is at JHU, then she is smart. Whatever I just told that, whenever you are going for universal quantifier, specifically you should understand that whenever you are going for universal quantifier, you want to apply the implication. Here the statements represent about the implication. For everyone. For everyone, it's represent about all statement. So that particular moment of time, you can see about the universal quantifier followed by the variable. Variable is x, okay, and the symbol is represent about here is known as an at, because what the subject is doing, or what the subject is actually. The subject is being at the JTU. That is what at is being taken as a predicate. X is the variable which we have been taken out of. So x is at JTU. So once if you are writing, you want to write it, the first one is a startup, second that is a source, and next one will be the destination. You can take it like this. Our first one will represent about the term x is at JTU. So once if you are reading, the reading of the statement should be made like this: for all x, x is at JTU, which implies smart of x. So again, I mean repeating the statement, how to read the particular statement. For all x, x is at JTU, that is JHU, which implies, which implications, smart of x. Okay, so x is smart. So when I want to write it very clearly, that x is smart. Okay, so that is what the statement that you can see at the top, in what way they have been applied. For example, the next statement they given, all birds fly. Okay, so all birds fly. Here the predicate represent about what is the predicate. Again, I've been telling, because why I've been specifically telling in the sense, you want to understand which is predicate, which is very clearly actually what subject is doing or what the subject is. So the subject is flying actually, the birds. So here I'm just writing the predicate fly of bird. So first thing what I want to do it in the sense, first I want to mention how many birds, I don't know. How many birds are flying? I don't know, because I mentioned all the birds. So what I, in what way I'll be writing, for all x, birds of x, which implies fly of x, which means that which are all to be the bird I've been representing, all the birds are flying. That is the meaning for this particular line. And second thing is, again, I will go for that particular presentation. Yeah, when you go for quantifier, the note, see the note very clearly that in universal quantifier, we use simplification. That is, we were called as an conditional statements actually. Okay, so if birds of, first you are mentioning about birds of x, then the birds of x are fly of x. So here the statement is very clear to mention about the statement. Second thing is, every man respect his parent. So every man respect his parent. So we first want to represent what is a man. Man represent every man. So every represent about everyone, that we called as an x. So don't think that the x to be the one, you can call it as an any kind of representation starting from an alphabet. But for the pronunciation, that be convenient to be give some kind of good. That is why I'm just putting for all x. So the predicate represent about here, every man respect his parents. So what subject is doing, or what subject is being, so here the subject is representing about, they are representing, they are respecting the parents. So who is representing parents? Every man is representing parent. So who is that every man? Every man will be called it as an x. Parent, who is that parent? That may be an every parent, because the statement I want to make it that every man respect is every parent. That is the statement I want to understand. So here you can able to very clearly, they given as x is a man and y is a parent. So respect is a predicate. So I want to write a statement that for all x, man of x, which means that respect of x comma parent, which means that who are all the man, okay, who are all the man, in the sense, who are all the, for all x, who are all the man, definitely each implies that x represent the parent. So first thing is, which particular person you are representing, that you should mention that. Then you can go for implies, then give the respects of x comma parent. Okay, now you can understand the universal quantification, how the implication is being applied. Number one, before applying the implication, you want to apply the predicate statement. That is very important, how the predicate statement is being applied by each and everyone. Okay, so let we go for the next one. So how the universal quantifiers will be applied to be taken to the real time of example. So you can see that brothers are siblings. So when I'm writing brothers or siblings, so that particular moment of time, we don't know brothers, but we know the one specific thing, brothers are represent about two persons, x comma y. So I'm just writing the statement for all x comma y, or you can also write the statement like for all x, for all y, brothers of x comma y, which implies siblings of x comma y. So you can also write the statement something like that. The next statement, you can also write a statement something like sibling is a symmetric. So sibling is a symmetric in the sense that x comma y, the sibling will also be called as an y comma x. So you can also take it as a symmetric. But only one thing is, once if you are writing a symmetric, which we called as a statement in the logical connectivities, the last logical connectivity is what we see in the proposition logic statement, which is called as an biconditional statements. So already I given some kind of examples for your biconditional statement. If I want to breathe, I want alive. I want to leave, I want to breathe. So these two statements are dependent between one another. So I won't tell that because of this happened, this has happened. So both the peoples are biconditionals, depend on both the people. So here we called as a symmetry, which represent an another term of a representation, which we called as a biconditional. That is why the statement we written as for all x, for all y, sibling of x comma y can also be called as a sibling of y comma x, which is nothing but y is a sibling of x, maybe in the right hand side. In the left hand side, when I'm talking about the statement, I can write it as an x is a sibling of y. So that's why we called as a biconditional statements. Let me come to the last one, which is very specific statement that you should understand, and let take some time. One's mother is a one's female parent. So here you want to take it something to be very clear that one's mother is one's a female parent. Okay, so these two terms are definitely interrelated with one another. You can see very specifically they given how the biconditional statements are applied. Okay, for all x, for all y, x is a mother of y, that I may make it. So if x is want to be a mother of y, definitely you want to be a female, and you want to be a parent. So both the things are same. Okay, that is why they also given the biconditional statements over here. So once you practice these statements on writing different kinds of statements that we will do in future, one by one as an exercises, as an assignments. So that particular moment of time, you can clearly know that what kind of an logical connectivities or what kind of a quantifiers, where implication to be applied, what is predicate, what is an object, what is the relationship that is going to be made at, everything you can able to done it actually. Okay. And next one will be called as an existential quantifier actually. So what is an existential quantifier? Existential quantifier, already we just make it the statement like there exists at least one. Okay, so when you are taking that kind of statement, for example, here they given very specific statement, something like some boys play cricket. Here some boys play cricket represent, play represent about the predicate. And who plays cricket actually? Boys plays cricket actually. So boys represent X and the Y represent about the cricket or the game. You can take it in any aspects actually. Okay, so here the predicate represent play of x comma y, which represent x plays y, which means that boys play cricket. So when I'm writing that particular statement, okay, when I'm writing that particular statement, this statement is not the right one actually. Why? In the sense, because I want to specifically want to mention one thing actually. Whenever you are specifying that existential quantifier, you want to mention that it is an, that it is a very specific statement, that is your conjunction statements. Okay, so here we want to mention that for all x, boy of x and play of x comma cricket, that is the right one to be taken. Maybe the next statement is giving the right one. Some boys are intelligent. Who is that some boys? I don't know who is some boys actually, but they are intelligent. So I'm just mentioned about there exists x, boys of x and intelligent of x. So there are some boys, and that boys definitely they are intelligent. So when I'm taking this kind of statements, okay, definitely you want to use a statement known as a conjunctive statement that we will do as an exercise in the future. The last statement, there is someone who studied at Lando and is smart. So here the study at will be called as a predicate statement, and someone will be called as an X1, and who is that someone is also a smart. So here they given very, very specifically they made it X is someone, someone studies at Lando, and who studies at Lando is a smart. So who is that? That person is X. That's what you can able to see that. And specifically why I am taken this particular statement in the sense, whenever I, when taking the proposition logic statement, I given the priority of symbols which is given over here. So here the priority will be given for the parenthesis which you are going to be carried out. So here you can see that the first priority will be go to the internally which what we applied, that is studies at X comma Lando and the smart of X. So these two things will be taken as a priority once if you are writing the existential quantifiers. And what are the properties of an quantifiers? That is very important actually. So what are the properties of quantifiers? we can able to know it, which are all the quantifiers we can make it, what kind of statements when you are writing, what are the different kinds of statements, the same statements can able to taken in different way actually. For example, you can take the first statement, for all x, for all of y is same as for all y and as well as for all x. So you can also write the statement like this. Second statement, there exists y, there exists there exists x and there exists y is the same as there exists y and there exists x, that is also the same. But the third statement is very crucial, that there exists x for all y is not same as for all y there exists x, which is something like the statements, if you want to understand very clearly, like some students like someone likes everyone, everyone likes someone, these two statements are not same actually. So that's what they commit over the statement with the third point, which they mention there exists x for all y is not same as the for all y and there exists x. Okay, so you can see the fourth one, there is a person who loves everyone in the world. So there is a person, what I just told about there exists, there exists represent about some people, or even a single person is also represented as in there exists. So that is why they mention about there is a person. Who is a person? I don't know, but there is a person is available. So there is a person who loves everyone in the world. So here you can able to see that there exists x, that is a represent about there exists a person who loves everyone, that is who loves everyone will be called as an for all y. Who loves everyone will be called as an for all y. Okay, so we will call it as an loves of x comma y, that is x represent about a person, a single person, and y represent about the person which we called as an everyone in the world. So here they specifically mentioned the term. Let me go to the next one. Everyone in the world is loved by at least one person. So here the term has been different. That's why I just told, when you are writing the third point, there exists of x and for all y is not same as in for all y and there exists x. So when I writing the fifth point, you can be able to very clear that for all y there exists x, which represent love of x comma y, that everyone, that x is represent everyone loves at least one person, that at least one person is the represent of your there exists y, that is there exists x over here they represented. And the last one represent about the duality. Duality represent about, see, when you are writing some kind of statements, you can also write some kind of propositional or negation statements can also be written. Maybe you can write it that for all x, likes of x comma ice cream, which means that x likes ice cream. All persons like ice creams. So that all persons like ice creams only, that what the statement is being written, all persons will be taken as a x person. So I'm writing a statement known as an for all x, likes of x comma ice cream, so x likes ice cream. Or the second statement I can able to make it, there exists x, likes of x comma the statement whatever they given over here. So that's, so even that particular statement you can also take it as a negotiation statement in the right hand side, they written over not of there exists x, which means that it represent for all. So even that particular statements also you can able to make it that if not everyone like it the ice creams. So you can also negotiation some kind of statements to be made at the quantify the equal opposite statements you can able to derive by using the quantifiers of your universal as well as the extensional quantifiers. Okay, so I think that this particular will give you some kind of an knowledge how, what is predicate, what is quantifier, what is universal quantifier, what is the syntax and regulations to be followed for the universal quantifier, and what is extensional quantifier, and what is the note to be very specifically we can want to take in for the extensional quantifier when you are writing the statement that you want to concentrate on the conjunction. Whenever you are writing the universal quantifier, you want to concentrate on the implication, which what we call as in conditional statements. So here, this all thing to be combined, we will take in another one kind of a session which specifically concentrate on how we want to convert it to the first order logic statements. So before going to end of the session, let me take some kind of very basic examples. This is where the questions will be asked you when you're going for an examination process. So the question is, you can fool all the people some of the time and some of the people all the time, but you cannot fool all the people all the time. So here you can able to see that you can fool all the people some of the time. Here all the people represent for all, and some of the time will be represent there exist. Some of the people will be represented as there exist all the time represent for all, but you cannot. So here you want to understand one thing. See, whenever you are writing this kind of universal quantifiers or an extensional quantifiers, you are also want to be concentrated on one particular name known as in connectivities. Definitely connectivity will take more kind of work when you are taking over joining the universal quantifiers, let us actually. So here you can see that, but you cannot fool, which means that you cannot represent about not negotiation symbol. You want to add the negotiation symbol before the universal quantifier. Okay, so you can able to take this three this particular paragraph. You want to assign as a three atomic statements. Number one statement, you can fool all the people some of the time. Statement number one. Statement number two. Okay, statement number two will be called as an and. You want to very specifically mention an and. So and to be called as a conjunction. What is the second statement? Some of the people all the time. That is the second statement. And what is the third statement? But you cannot. But you in the sense that is also going to be added. But you cannot fool all the people all the time. So here you can see at the bottom in what way they write it. That is for all P. That is the P represent about the person. All the people. There exists a time, which is some of the time you can fool. That is, all the people can able to fool some of the time. And here the second statement represent, before the second statement, you want to add the and symbol because and symbol has been made it. Okay, that is a representation of your conjunction. The second statement is some of the people all the time. Some of the people here, the some of the people represent about there exist. All the time will be taken as in for all T. Okay, so here we can able to make it the statement that some of the people all the time and. Because they make it, but you cannot in the sense that is also the statement that will be added. So that is a statement and is being added, but you cannot will be called as a not symbol. That is why you can see that I've been added the negotiation symbol in front of the for all. So cannot all the people will mean that whenever I've been writing not of all people, if you want to write the equivalent statement, you can also give that exist, which means that it is not mean that all the people. Which means that there are some people is available that you cannot able to fool at all the time. That is what the specific term that they are able to mention over there. So here, if I want to take some other equivalent term, if I want to some other quantifier, if I want to substitute it for that, the same statement I can able to make it there exist of P, which is also means that I, there are some people which or some people where I cannot able to. Make that particular people to be fooled. That is a representation for that. So I think you can understand this example. Okay, let me go to the and I think you can able to understand what is first order logic predicate statement, what is predicate, and what are all the properties of the quantifiers, and what are the limitations, and how to construct the first order logic statement for the given one. And whenever you are concentrating in concentration on your universal quantifier as well as an existential quantifier, make it one note to be very specifically note that amplification should be applied when you go for universal quantifier, and as well as when you go for existential quantifier, you want to apply the conjunction symbol. And in future we will see more number of first order logic statements, and as well as in how to convert it to the further level of work to combine the both propositional logic statement as well as the first order logic statements to be taken to the next level, we called as a resolution, that we will see in the future sessions. So for further videos you can visit arunai.org/tem. okay, so thank you for your patience.